Hi everyone, my name is Kevin. I work as a program manager at Microsoft, and today I want to show you how you can record a meeting in Microsoft Teams. It's very easy to do. Now, first off, why would you ever want to record a meeting in Microsoft Teams? Well, maybe let's say you work as a teacher and one of your students is absent today and you want them to be able to catch up on the class. Or maybe you work at an office and one of your coworkers is unable to attend an important meeting and you want them to be able to catch up. Well, you could provide the recording to them. Whatever your reason is for recording, the good news is it's very easy to do. And so enough talk, why don't we jump on the PC and I'll show you how to do this. And just as a note, I'm gonna show you how to do it on the desktop. However, even on your mobile device, you could set up a recording in a very similar way. All right, well, let's jump to it. Here I am on my desktop and I have Microsoft Teams open and here I am in the calendar view. And so I'm looking at my day today and what meeting should I record? Well, there's one coming up at 2 p.m. today called the Big Important Meeting. This is probably gonna be a good one to record. I'll go ahead and click into that. Now, I don't know if Stephanie or Megan will be able to make it today. So this will be a good one to record. Now I'm here in the meeting and let me go ahead and just join the meeting. Okay, so now I'm in the meeting and it looks like it's just waiting for other people to join. So one of the things I wanna do is I wanna share some content, and so I'm gonna click on share my screen and then I'll share this PowerPoint presentation called the European Expansion. So what this will do is this will open the presentation and, you know, now I might wanna kick off my discussion about the European expansion. And so I wanna record this because no one else has joined the meeting yet. Now to record the meeting, I mentioned before that it's very simple to do, and all you need to do is when you hover over, you get these controls down here, you're gonna click on the ellipses or the dot, dot, dot. And that's the more actions option. And when I click on that, you get a list of a whole bunch of different options, but the one we're interested in today is the one that says start recording, the one with the little red circle icon. And I'm gonna go ahead and click on that. And now what'll happen is this kicks off the recording of the presentation. Now, as a good practice, what I would recommend doing is make sure you tell other people in the meeting that you will be recording the meeting. One of the things that Teams will do is it'll show a message to both you and all of the participants that tells everyone that there's a recording in progress, and that sounds good. So I'm gonna go ahead, let's dismiss this message for now, and I could jump through my presentation, I could go through the different slides, and all of this is being recorded. Now, once I'm done with my recording, what I can do is I could click on more actions and I could stop the recording, or I could simply end the meeting, and that also effectively stops the recording. One thing to note is down here in the bottom left-hand corner, you could also see the amount of time that has elapsed for the recording. So now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead, let's just click on stop recording. And here it says the meeting is being recorded. Are you sure you want to stop? Yes, I am. So let's go ahead and click on stop recording. And what I could do now is I could hang up and leave the meeting. Now, one of the things you'll see is the recording is being saved and it's going to be processed and stored in Microsoft Teams. Okay, so let's go ahead and dismiss this. I'm going to hang up from the meeting. And one of the things you'll see now is the meeting recording has stopped and it's being saved to Microsoft Stream. Now I did a recording earlier just to show what this looks like, but as soon as the video has processed, you'll see it available within the meeting chat. So when you're in the meeting, you'll see up here, there's a pivot called chat. You'll find the recording right there. And the other way that you could get to the recording is via Microsoft Stream. Now to get to Microsoft Stream, what you can do is if you navigate to office.com, you can then use this to access all of the different apps that are part of Microsoft 365. So here on the office.com homepage, I have an app tile for Stream. If you don't have it on your homepage, you could also click on all apps here, and then you can navigate down to Microsoft Stream, and that's another way you can get to it. So I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna click on Stream, and that's gonna load the experience. So once I'm in Microsoft Stream, what I wanna do is to get to my meeting recording, what I can do is here you see on this top bar, you have a bunch of different options. I'm gonna click on My Content on this dropdown, and within this dropdown, also a number of options. The one we're interested in is called Meetings. So this is all of your content related to meetings that you've been part of. So I'm gonna go ahead and click on here. This is also a place where you can see all of your meeting recordings. And here you see the big important meeting recording right here. I could even go ahead and click on it and that'll play the screen recording that I just did. What's nice is not only will it tell you the title of the meeting, it'll also tell you who it was recorded by, who it was organized by, and when the meeting took place. So it inserts some nice information up front. And what'll happen now is it'll go through the content that I shared in the meeting. Here you see my European expansion deck, and it'll include the voices, anyone else who talked. It'll include that all as part of the recording. And that's really as simple as it is. It's very easy to record a meeting in Microsoft Teams. All right, well, that was just a quick video showing you how to record a meeting in Microsoft Teams. If this video helped you, please give it a thumbs up. If you want to see more helpful videos like this in the future, please subscribe to the channel. That way you'll get updates and notifications anytime new content comes out. All right, well, that's all I had for you today. We hope to see you again. Bye.